Yes, YouTube, welcome back to Content Pre Collectibles. Today, we have the brand new One Piece set, OP04, Kingdoms of Intrigue. If you're just as pumped as I am to open this and get some hits, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below what card you're most pumped about. Remember, this is early access exclusive. The set does not come out until the 22nd of September. Like the video if you're hyped about this. Let's get it. Okay, guys, without further ado, here we go. Let's crack into this bad boy. Seal has been broken. Oh, yes. Come on down. There it is, brand new in its packaging. Nice artwork. We actually have a white bottom box. Here we go. No box toppers. Okay. I wasn't sure if they were going to have box toppers or not. We don't have any in this time. Don't know how I feel about that. If we get some juicy hits, I'll be fine. I think I'll put the box right there. So there we have it, guys. All the packs for Kingdoms of Intrigue. Dude, if we hit something crazy in here, I'm going to be so pumped. Oh my god. So we're going to have a bit more of a look at these cards. We're going to have a bit more of a study of the art, of the text, of the wording. Before we do get into that, though, I actually have two pre-release packs of Kingdoms of Intrigue. So let's get these cracked. Okay, so I believe you get two cards in each pack. Okay, so we have the Corridor Coliseum. That has the pre-release stamp right there. And we have Lao G with the pre-release. Okay, just a little something there. Cards feel fantastic. One Piece cardstock is so good. So good. What have we got next? We have the Banana Gator pre-release and Playgrounds. I haven't actually played with blue yet. I do want to get into it. If anyone has a good blue set, hit me down in the comments below. I'll check it out. Without further ado, first pack, here we go. Like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're as hyped as I am for the OP04 One Piece TCG fourth installment. Here we go. We have that baseball dude from Big Mom's Pirates. Chin Zhao, headbutting guy. Yeah. This for anyone who doesn't know or is not familiar, or maybe you're here just from the Netflix live action, this set, this current set, is from the Dressrosa arc, which is one of the Warlords of the Sea, his kind of domain. So, Dressrosa, Don Quixote, Flamingo. So we have a chopper there. Pay up to one animal type character with 3000 power or less from your hand, 1k counter. Nice. Okay, apparently this stage is what you need if you're playing Rebecca, which is the new leader in this set. Okay, what's this we got? Rest up to one of your opponent's leaders or characters, then KO up to one of your opponent's rested leaders or characters, 6 or less, 5 cost. Set up to 5 of your Don cards as active as a trigger, that's crazy, wow. That's definitely going to see some play in green. Green isn't the strongest set. Well, it wasn't before this anyway. I've not played purple before. Okay, this is actually a black one, so a navy. You may rest your leader. Give up to one of your opponent's characters -4 cost during this turn. Not bad. Alright. A 2k counter, okay, super build spot duck. You may give your Okay, it's an interesting one. Okay, so our first shiny is Ulti. And our first super rare is Sugar. Okay. Wow, that does look nice. It's kind of a bit more anime style, fun type with the background. How are we feeling this? Are we liking the art? Are we digging it? I'm enjoying it. I think I'm so hyped for a new set, guys. It's been too long. Next pack. Here we go. Okay, Hanger. I don't remember this guy. You may trash one card from your hand, rest his card to draw one card. Don't play blue. Okay, these are the guys from the... Oh, it's not Mainford. What's the name of the CP9 place? Ennis Lobby. Yes! Mental game. Dellinger, this crazy dude with heels. Arabian. Okay, I know there are some yellow cards here that are actually pretty good. Oh, we got a yellow Otama. Okay. And it's one of your animal or smile type cards with a cost of 3 or less at the top of your opponent's life cards face up. That's an interesting one. Really cool art. Barrier. Black. Okay. It's one of your 2000 power. Then if you have 15 or more cards in your trash. Okay. Not bad. Apis. That girl with the dragon. We got the hedgehog. Trash this character. Okay, I think that's more like a Yamato card. We've got a Blue Jack. Diablo Jumbo Joshut. So one of your leader gains 6,000 power during this battle. Then if you... Ooh, that's tasty. That's pretty tasty. Okay, so we got a Diamante and a Rebecca. So this is the actual leader. This isn't the leader card, obviously, but this this specific character does have a leader card in this set, which we're hoping to pull. Hoping, guys. So obviously I'm bringing this to you early. The set does not come out until the 22nd of September. Got a few connections. That's cringe. And we have, we got a super rare Sabo. Very cool. So it's a blocker. Nice. That's a cool card, okay. Say that's our first real hit. But no, I was lucky enough to find some boxes. Obviously, people shouldn't be really selling it right now because it hasn't actually been released to the public. So, Rabian, we have Randolph, Yokozuna from Water 7, Happiness Punch, where Nami flashes her enormous jabs and gives everyone nosebleeds. We have Charlotte Moscato. There we go. Okay, so we have Bad Manners Kick Course. Trash one card from your hand up to one of your leader or character cards gains 3000 power. Okay, and we have a Capone Gang Beji. We didn't get a Don card. Did we not get a Don card in every... Oh yeah, that's a good point, actually. Not been getting Don cards. Interesting. Okay, so we've got some pretty cool art. Adjust this a little bit. Very nice, very cool. We take those. Okay, next pack. Gonna go through these a bit quicker. The Nanigator, Hanger, Charlotte Perospero. Okay, Mr. 13, Miss Friday, Gun Madoki. I think that's also a Yamato card. We have Baby 5. We have Suleiman and Kiros and a Chaka. Yeah, no Don cards. Okay. I wasn't aware that they'd done that. So there's no Don cards in the actual back of the pack. This is the first time they've actually done that in the sets. Interesting. Okay. We have Olympus. That dude, Tom San. Great character. Rocky. Perispero. Pelolin. We have Viola. Cool character. You may rest two Don. Rest to one of your opponent's Don cards. Okay, that's interesting. We have a red Luffy. Cool. 9k damage. We have a leader crocodile. Okay, and then we have King and Heavenly Fire. Okay, so we got a yellow card. Add up to one of your opponent's characters with a cost of 3 or less to the top or bottom of your opponent's locker. That's okay. Okay, we carry on. There is a Sanji yellow card that I'm looking for to add to the category deck. So we're hoping to be pulling that. Kung Fu Dugong, which I'll probably take another look at. We can do Luffy again. We have Crocodile again. We have Charlotte Amade. Once per turn, you may trash a card with the trigger from your hand, rest up to one of your opponent's characters at the cost of 2 or less. Okay, that's not too bad. 2k counter though, can't complain with those. And I think this is our Don card. Okay, so there it is. This is our Don card. So it's actually the scene from Alabasta. The VV Don card. Looking pretty nice. I'm sure people will be running sets of those. I personally like the Shanks from Paramountwar. It's probably my favourite Don card that they've done. Black Maria. It's pretty crazy, isn't it? Not focusing very well. There we go. Okay, we're gonna go through these a little bit faster. We have that dude. Gun Madoki again. Those sneaky animals. Okay, we have another Rebecca and oh yes! There we go, good dudes, my dudes. We have the Edward Newgate character. This is like a new trippy art that they have. It is, dude, he is looking pretty scary actually. It's pretty morbid. Like, you can tell he just looks like washed out. Really nice though, really nice texturing on the back of the card. Obviously this card is the one that was actually restricted, so people were actually running 4 of these at the time, but yeah, there's a bit of a close-up. That's a good hit, guys. That's a good hit. We take those. Okay, hit the like button, my dudes. That's the kind of energy we want up in here. Okay, next pack. Karu. We have the Samurai Sword Salesman dude. Trafalgar Law. Just the no ability one. Vanilla card. Happiness Punch. So funny. The art is so funny on that. I love that. Really good taste of these cards. This guy is the worst. Really snotty dude. Okay, we got another sugar. Okay, so you can have duplicates in this pack as well. I don't think you had them in the last sets. Don't remember getting duplicates of super rares. Could be wrong. Message me if I'm wrong. Comment down below, I mean. We have Barrier again. That's purple. This looks like a good green card. I've actually built a new kid deck. Kid is actually doing really well in Japan. Okay, so we have, this is the leader VV card, which you could actually get in, I believe it was Romancedawn or maybe Paramountwar, you could get the VV card. Okay, so we got a king and we have a Kinemon. Oh, we have another Don card. Wow, look at this. This is a first. This is actually a first. You only ever got one Don card in the set. But we've actually been given two. Okay, so this is something brand new for Kingdoms of Intrigue, OP04. That's pretty cool. It'll probably reduce the price a bit down because it'll be much easier to get. I think only giving one Don, not giving Don card in the back of every pack is actually quite a clever idea. Will they make it so you can only get Don cards from the first 3 sets and the starter decks? That would be quite interesting. Okay, we've got Mr. 5 and we have a Trunin Bastardo. Okay, so this is actually a black event. Let's have a look. Choose up to one of your opponent's cards at the cost of 4 or less and KO it if you have 15 more cards. Okay, it's a bit like the Bartholomew one. Okay, that sounds pretty cool. I always like checking out a new set. Like I said, guys, we're going to be taking a bit of a closer look at these ones. We're not just flying through like we normally do. I normally just speed opening. Okay, and there is the Kuro card. 6-drop, 8k damage. Some of you coming from the Netflix show will probably recognize this guy. He is the evil butler who tries to steal Kaya's inheritance. Steal, I mean murder to get it. Okay, we got a 1-drop Sanji. Coat hanger dude. Otama again, brilliant art. I really like that one. What's this one? Enchanting vertical dance. This is alabaster type, give up to... Okay, it's quite expensive for 3. Oh, that's really nice. So that's actually a 5-drop Zoro. 1k counter. Give up to one of your opponent's characters minus 2,000 power during this turn. Okay, that's pretty nice. And what's this back card? Oh, nice. I really like that. That's so cool. That's so cool. Pretty dark. It's purple. I don't ever run purple. But that's a really nice card. We got a Robin Schwan. Okay, so we're just over halfway through, starting on the right hand side. I do have another box to open, guys. So if you hit that like button, subscribe down below and comment, I'll do another opening, see what else we get. I mean, if we get something, we already got something pretty crazy, to be fair. Obviously wanting those leader cards, Sabo manga art would be insane. So there's a Rebecca leader card. And this dude, Snotty Treble. Just the worst devil fruit power in the entire series, in my opinion. He literally just grabs on people. Chin Zhao, actually a really cool character development with him. Kung Fuji. Okay, so if you have content with this character, gains blocker. That's pretty sick. That's pretty sick. I don't know why my camera's not focusing. Okay, so we got a new Nami-san. Jed spilling out all over the place. It's the... Okay. There's the Otama again. Lao Ji. We have a Bon Cray. I always want to say Clay, but yeah. There's the Charlotte Amandi as well. And we have a Kaido. Super rare. Okay, return up to one character with the cost of 8 or less. Okay, it's pretty interesting. So I am actually colorblind, but I think this is blue, not purple, which is really cool. That sounds like a really good addition to the Warlords deck. So we got another Kuro, 6-drop. I'm gonna just, you can come over here, my dude. We have Miss Golden Week. Chopper, Barrier, Apis, Happiness Punch, we've got an Aesop. KO to one of your opponent's characters with 5,000 base power or less. That's pretty sick on KO. Okay. We have the leader card, BV again, and an ulti. Okay. Remember, guys, this isn't just the only opening I've done. I'm actually on a chase to get the Manga Shanks, the most expensive card in the One Piece TCG set, and I'm not stopping until I've pulled it. So if you want to see someone suffer through misery and pain and financial woe, hit the button that should be popping up right here. Anyway, back to it. We have Trafalgar Law, Toko. We have Baby 5. So two of your non-cards are active. 2k counter, that'll definitely see some play. We have an Isho, a Cavendish, and a Mr. 5 who flicks his bogeys and explodes people with them. Yeah. How do you think about that? Flicking a bogey. Stussy. CP0. Look at 3 cards from Tokyo Duck. Okay. Okay, that's like a weaker version of... Oh, what's that knobhead called? Excuse my French. Spanden. Another searcher for CP9. So we have Nez Palm Cannon, purple. 2k County Gats. We got another 2k Zoro. 1k Zoro. Okay, next pack. Can we get something crazy from the rest of these packs? Stick around to find out, guys. We have Tom, Kung Fu Jugon, Stussy, really cool art. Waifu taxing a bit. And we have Cobra. All of your Alabaster type characters other than this character gain 1,000 power. Okay, so that's like a VV card. There's the Colosseum, which I'm told you have to play this card, this stage, if you want to play the Rebecca character. We have Hera. Okay, you may trash one of your homies. I believe those are the cards that Big Mom creates, so like benches and broomsticks and all that kind of shit. Zeus as well. The rest of the cards end up to one of y'all. Okay, that's pretty damn good actually. Ho! Ho! My dudes, we just pulled one of the best cards in the set. Ho! Shit! No way, we actually did it on the first box. Wow, I'm so impressed. This card looks crazy good. So we got the Rebecca leader card. Guys, hit that like button. Come on, we're only pulling fire in these videos. Hit that like button, guys. Help me out with the algorithm. Contemporary Collectibles is a brand new channel. If you like this content, if you're just watching to kick a chill and watch me open some cards, like I encourage you to do, hit that like button, my dudes. It's free. It helps me out so much. And I really appreciate it. We are straight up gas. Wow. I'm buzzed with that. Oh, and we got a crocodile. That looks pretty sick as well, actually. Is that super rare? Purple crocodile. I think the purple deck is all about Don manipulation. So returning Don to your Don deck, bringing it back out again, returning your opponent's Don, that kind of thing. So like I said, I've never played with a purple deck, but it sounds pretty sick. This one, Carmo, she's a really interesting character. This character is to do with Big Mom's backstory for anyone who hasn't seen the anime or watched. Or read the manga or anything like that. Okay, Sasaki, we have Trunin Bastardo. Senior Pink, yes. I was actually really looking forward to pulling this guy. He is one of the best characters in the entire manga. Hands down. You don't like him at first, but when you find out about his backstory, it is just crazy. How did Oda think up that? Is that one Don? Return if your leader has the Don Quixote Pyro Express up to one of your opponent's characters will cost a 4 or less and then set one of your... Okay, that's not too bad. That's kind of like a watered down version of the Kuro leader card. Definitely sounds pretty good. So we got a Sanji, another Kuro, Pound, we got Otama, another Colosseum. Wow, they're pretty abundant. We got Iceberg. Purple Iceberg. There's a normal leader. I can't believe we just pulled that. And we have a Who's Who and a Colors Trap. Nice. So we're getting actually pretty early on in the manga with some of these cards, which I love to see. I love the early stuff. For everyone who's watching the Netflix animation, like the live action, just know it's totally different from the actual manga and anime. Anime follows it reasonably closely. Like it does its best to follow it. Whereas the live action is kind of like an artistic interpretation of it. Definitely not canon. It seems to nail some of the main bits, but don't think of it as an exact storytelling. Oh, we got it. Okay, so this is actually the card that I wanted to add to my Katakuri deck. Keeps on focusing for some reason. So after your opponent declares an attack, you may rest his card. Okay, so we've got the 4-drop 5k blocker, which also has a trigger. That's his, this is a crazy card. This is a really good card. Probably running two, maybe even four of these alongside, if you wanted to go crazy, you'd run them alongside the brulee blockers as well, which would be a bit of more of an interesting dynamic because the Katakuri deck is very aggressive, hyper-aggressive, aggro. I don't know how it would do on the defensive side. Could be good, not too sure. So we have Nami, Toniyasu, we have Gum Gum King Kong, which is black. So for 3 drop, up to one of your Dressrosa, okay, so it's a Dressrosa one. We have Usopp, Cavendish again, and Spiderweb, which is green. Up to one of your leader or character cards gains 4,000 power during this battle. Then set one of your characters as active. Wow, that's really good. That's really good. In fact, I'm going to put that into my kid deck because that's insane. It's a bit similar to Punk Gibson. But I can't remember the second text on Punk Gibson. Got one here, actually. Banana Gator. So this is the last pack, guys. If you've enjoyed this content, if you've enjoyed these pulls, I'll just go over them again in a moment. Please like the video. Please comment down below. And if you really enjoyed it, I'd really appreciate a sub to the channel, guys. That would mean the world to me. Thank you so much for watching. Just going to have a quick look here. Hiyori, Kozuki, but so one of your Lander Wanna type, 1000 power, 2k counter, that'd be good for Yamato deck. Flapping Thread, okay, what's this? So for 2 cost, if your lead has Donkey, okay, another Don Quixote, okay, we got an Olin Lin. Okay, just a vanilla card with a trigger, and we have, to finish us off, a purple 2k counter, Frankie. Awesome. Okay, guys, so our two big hits are the textured, is it gonna focus? Are you gonna focus? Yeah. So we have the textured Newgate caricature 9-drop restricted card. So this is the one that's actually restricted. It's just kind of like a new art that they've done. Really cool, bit dark, bit sinister. It's he's got sad eyes. Don't know if you can see. He's got sad eyes, my dudes. But a really nice, flavorful card. Oh my god, can I pick this up? Okay, and we do have the big hit. I believe this is one of the best cards in the entire set. I probably will put prices on just because I know some people like that, but remember, this product isn't released yet. It comes out on the 22nd of September, so they'll be inflated, the prices. They will definitely come down. So there we have the Rebecca card. Guys, that is so nice. So nice. Just look at the colouring. Look at the... It just... Blue, green, yellow. Wow. I'm so chuffed. Awesome. So guys, if you've enjoyed this content, please give me a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe to Contemporary Collectibles. We've got so many cool videos in the pipeline. I'm also running for the Manga Shanks. We're opening as many Romance Dawn boxes as possible. We're not stopping until we pull it. It's either going to be my downfall or we're going to do it and we're going to rise to Valhalla together. Guys, if you've enjoyed it, I salute, and remember, everyone's going through something, so please be kind, and I'll catch you in the next video.